took your heart. I did things to your only lovers would do in the dark. It made you a god. Priests, popes, and preachers would tell me I did wrong, but hey, it made a nigga flip. What do I say to make me exist? Oh, stranger. Still don't know my name. Still don't know my name. And I would die a slave, and right now. But you still don't know my name.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This video is about few things that I think were important and helped me in creating my first own act. It's called the UTOPIA, the Perfect India. It's on my YouTube channel. You can go and check it out if you haven't watched it yet. And also my exams are nearing. It's in December, so can't really focus seriously on content making. So just thought of creating this short video which might be helpful to some of you and may help you in creating your own act. So yeah, without any further ado, let's get into the video. So a little bit from the previous effect is that so for the layman, there's an effect in magic where you take something, tear it, and then put it back together, and that's why it's called the tone and restored effect. So the problem with the original tone and restored effect was that you take a normal card and then you tear that card from the center and then you put it back together, but that leaves you with a folded card and nothing to wonder about. But with this effect, you are left with an impossible object. You create an impossible object with that cool animation of the card shifting and locking its place and then restoring, and with the signatures of the spectator on this card, I just can't wait to perform this on the streets and just hand this to the spectator so that they can remember the whole process. So yeah, that was it. That was something I wanted to share. So yeah, now let's talk about how did I just came up with the act? How did I just one day thought of creating this whole act? So firstly, I think from seeing great magicians having their own act, and secondly, I didn't have a theatrical stage act which I could perform on stage and would look beautiful with music synchronized and all. And thirdly, the pandemic. I had the idea of the act but didn't actually have the time to invest in. So just 2 to 3 months after the pandemic, I got the materials from the market. After the markets reopened, I got the materials, made the whole structure, got ready with the storyline, and then just started building the act. And yeah, that's how I started creating the whole act. Okay, so now let's get into creating this whole act. So firstly, I think there is no right way or wrong way of creating art, but previously what I used to do is I used to think of particular individual magic effects and then join them together and then try to form a storyline around those magic effects. But recently I just thought of giving the utmost priority to the storyline. So just locked myself into a room, just got rid of all the magic ideas I have and just focused on completing the whole story, and then come up with different magic effects which might deliver certain emotions. But still I think my idea has many cliche lines, but yeah, that's important. and having the whole storyline first will also help you structuring certain magic effects into the place. So now let's talk about the graph. What is the graph? Here I'm talking about the graph of the astonishment quality, if that's a term, of a particular magic effect. So it has to start from here and then it just has to go up. So the main time-consuming part of the whole act was to come up with a perfect opener, because people do judge book by its cover. So something very quick, something visual and relatable has to be the opening of the act. So in my act, I'm just thinking of a dream turning into a reality. So turning a photograph into a real object went quite well with it, and hence decided to keep that as the opener of the act. So one conscious thing I did was to add offbeat components to the act. Just try to not keep playing cards in the act, just because it's everywhere. So got some blank cards, designed some particular drawings, and then got them printed. And also adding fire, rice grains, and flower petals made the act a lot more diverse and not boring maybe. So yeah, I think adding offbeat components is certainly important. Okay, so now let's talk about my most favorite part of this video, music design. So this is initially where it all started. Okay, so there's this commercial of Apple. It was of the MacBook Air, and it had used the song called Trampoline. And I heard the song, I don't know how, I just had the initial thoughts of the act, and that's how the bass track of the act got selected. And also I think synchronizing each of the climaxes of individual magic effect to the particular beats was very crucial. If not all of them, most of them were synchronized. And that's why it took so long and so many attempts to film the whole act in one take, because I missed few beats and it just didn't sound right. So I think synchronizing music to your act is an essential. Okay, so now moving towards the end of this video, I'm gonna mention a few creative inspirations I had. Actually, I'm gonna tell you a very funny story that during that period of time, I tried not watching magic videos of other magicians, because I just didn't want my act to look like someone else's work. And also I tried to not get influenced by other magicians, but instead went on YouTube and searched for rappers, song producers, story writers, and got to know the story behind their creative process and how they come up with song ideas or story ideas. And I think that really helped. And also wanted to mention that I was lucky enough to have friends who gave me unbiased reviews of the act, gave me suggestions. And if you don't know Amazing David, he is one of the greatest magicians I have ever seen, and he was kind enough to enlighten me with some of his advices, and his ideas took the act to another level. And I just want to say thank you so much for doing that. And with that, we come to the end of another video. Nothing to say much. Just enjoyed the process of creating this whole act. Just enjoyed how I used to wake up every morning thinking of how can I solve the problems that the story demands, because it's magic, right? You write impossible things and then work yourself on how to make those things seem possible. And I'm gonna be coming up with a lot more of content after my exams are finished in this December. And till then, I'm gonna see you next time in the next video.